Hi, it's Beth and welcome back to my channel. Whoa, it's been a while since I've said that. I think the last video I uploaded on this channel, or anywhere, was my 2018 year in 365 seconds, which is a whole year and 3 months ago. So it's okay because I'm back now. Obviously, because of the whole situation that's happening in the world right now, I'm staying at home for I don't know how long, so get ready to see more of me online. But even though I haven't been uploading, I have filmed and edited a few videos from 2019. So I will be uploading them gradually after this video. So don't be confused when you see the next few videos I upload, because they will be from last year. But speaking of what is happening right now, obviously everyone is staying at home. Stay safe, stay healthy and everything, like wash your hands. I feel like that's a very basic thing that everyone should be doing anyway, but yeah, wash your hands. But it is my friend's birthday today and he's doing a Zoom birthday party. When I got that Facebook invite, I think it was yesterday, I feel like I should know this, like, does anyone else feel that this whole period, it feels like the awkward period between Christmas and New Year's when you just don't know what day it is, you don't know what time it is, you don't know what to do. Anyway, he has a Zoom birthday party tonight in an hour, so I thought might as well film a get ready with me and do sort of like an update on my life since I haven't been online for like ages. So I'm gonna start getting ready now and I'll put everything that I use in the description below if you wanna have a look at what I'm using. But yeah, time to put my hair up. So this makeup look is gonna be nothing special. Just put some brows on, maybe just like beautify this face, because I think there's like 40 something people logging in into this Zoom party and I don't know like majority of them. So I feel like I don't really want to show them this face yet, you know, unless they search me up and then they'll see this video or previous videos where I start off with no makeup. But you know, I feel like I should look a bit more human when I first meet people, hence get ready with me. I feel like I should just name the get ready with me's as like put brows on, because I literally like, I don't look like human if I don't have brows on, as you saw from the beginning. Also, I'm on the very end of this brow pencil, so I'm a bit worried, but it'll be fine. All is good. I just need enough for the other side and I'll be okay. Wow, do you see that? See that difference? So what should I talk about? What's happened since 2018? So much has happened. Well, for starters, I've graduated. I did it, barely. Graduated from Warwick with a psychology degree. And now I am, fun employed. I've sort of taken my time with, finding a job after graduation because I'm still trying to figure out what I want to do. And to anyone that's feeling that way now, in the future, or whenever, like, it's okay. Take your time. Really, like, think about what you want to do and what you want in life in the future, etc. And don't, like, make any rash decisions because it's your life, it's your time. So, like, do what you want. So, yeah, especially with what's happening now, I have a lot of time to really, like, be by myself in my own thoughts, think about what I want to do. So I'll update you when I find out. But yeah, right now I am fun employed. Okay, I fully ran out of this brow product. I'm gonna try and find if I have another one. If not, this will have to do. Okay, I have a thicker one, but I'm just gonna be really light-handed because this is quite, this is like a darker shade. Even though my hair is black, so like, how darker can you get? Okay, I think that's fine. Do I look human yet? I look so rough. Anyway, back to what I'm doing right now. Because I'm at home indefinitely, I'm sort of doing everything that I wanted to do, but like didn't have time for before. So like researching on things, watching things, catching up on sleep, catching up with people, you know. Whoa. This looks great. I feel like I should just go on the Zoom call like this. But yeah, I'm just, you know, enjoying life indoors. I feel like it's not that much different to like what I usually am anyways. Like I don't really go out even when we didn't have to self-quarantine. So yeah, I'm doing what I wanted to do before but didn't have time to do. And I feel like a lot of people are doing that right now because we have the time. What else am I doing? What else can I update you on? I've started watching those, I don't know if you guys know, but there's like these Chinese and Korean like web series on YouTube, and oh my goodness, I've like binge watched a few already. I actually found them during exam season in my final year, and oh my goodness, like it messed up my revision schedule. Like I would have days where I would block out and schedule my revision like to the hour, to the minute, and the day would go by and I wouldn't have started it, or like I would have gone halfway, and it was because I was watching a YouTube web series. The thing is, like, all of them are so predictable, like, you know what's gonna happen. I feel like that's with most like Asian dramas, like, you know what's gonna happen, but like, you still watch it because I don't know. I was just a little addicted back then, and it was not a good time to be addicted to those kind of things. But yeah, that's what I'm doing right now, other than some little projects I'm working on. Ooh, so secretive. It really isn't. Wow, this sponge is so hard. I think it might be because I've washed it so many times. But like, you're meant to wash your sponge, so like, I don't know why it's so hard. Anyway, back to uni talk. Was I talking about uni before? Yeah, I think so. My final year, because I didn't post any of that on here, was, let's say, interesting. I actually majored in dance with a side of psychology because, like, I'd say 80% of the time that I spent at uni was on the dance club. And in my final year, I was president, and it was like a job. Let's just say that if you are part of the executive committee of a sports club or a society at uni, you should have a good support group behind you, or like a group of friends that actually understand you and like lets you vent, because I feel like this is with anything, like working with people is so hard. Like especially when you don't like see eye to eye, but that's a whole video in itself, I feel. But yeah, in general, my final year was great. I passed, barely. But yeah, I look back, I speak like I've graduated like years ago. I literally graduated only a few months ago. But yeah, it was great. Would I do it again? Probably not. But it was cool. It was great. Did it. Graduated. Great. So as I'm blending out this bronzer slash contour, I kind of do the same thing. Like I only do one step. So I feel like this is contour because I don't know. I don't really know much about makeup, even though this whole channel is like me doing makeup. But as I'm blending this out, what can I talk about? Ooh, I had a Netflix party yesterday with two of my friends over Skype. Well, yeah, over Skype, and also the Netflix party extension thing. The Netflix party thing is where you can basically connect your Netflix account. So basically, like, if one person in the party pauses the movie or episode or whatever you're watching, everyone else's pauses, except the two people that I was watching with, their screens and stuff connected because they had Netflix accounts. But like, I didn't have a Netflix account, so I had to log into one of theirs. And it just, for some reason, didn't work. Like, when they paused, like, mine wouldn't pause. So I just had to do the old-fashioned way of counting down and, like, clicking together. It just reminded me of when I did that with my Hong Kong friends back in secondary school. Oh, what a time. But yeah, if you want to watch a movie or an episode with your friends on Netflix, download or install that Google Chrome Netflix Party extension and watch it with your friends. But, like, make sure you all have a Netflix account or else it won't work. Wow, I'm really bringing life to my face again with this blush. Oh, I've been trying to work out. Oh my gosh, keyword trying. Literally. So like, if you didn't know, I'm a dancer, whatever, I dance. And I always thought like, oh, because I dance, I should be like reasonably fit. So like, I shouldn't be panting if I go up and down the stairs. But after doing these home workouts that I found on YouTube, I'm questioning like if I've ever been healthy. Like, working out is hard. That sounds like such a first world problem. Such a whiny kid.
Working out is so hard.
But it genuinely is. Like, after I do like a few exercises, I'm literally like sweating, which I feel like you should be anyway for working out. But like, I feel like I should be able to do more. I don't know. But yeah, I've been working out at home, and like, I've set for myself to work out the moment I get up, or like, working out will be the first thing that I do when I get out of bed. And I think that's also why waking up right now in this period of time is so hard for me. Because, like, in my head, I'm kind of like, okay, the moment I wake up and get out of this bed, I'm gonna have to work out. Like, and I think that's why whenever I wake up, I literally lie in bed for like a good hour just scrolling on my phone because I know when I get out, I'm gonna have to work out. And working out is hard. Hearing myself say that out loud just sounds so dumb. But yeah, trying to work out. And in this self-isolation period right now, a lot of dance instructors are doing live dance classes, which I feel like is so cool for them to do that, like, for free as well. And I've tried to do a few, but sometimes the connection is just so bad and like so laggy. So after, to be honest, like after 10 minutes of one of the classes, I kind of like gave up and turned off the live and went back on my laptop. But there's an Instagram page with like a whole timetable of dance Instagram lives. So I'm gonna try again tomorrow, I think. No, I should try again tomorrow. I should dance again. Oh yeah, after I graduated, I haven't really gone to many dance classes, which is kind of sad because dancing is kind of like my favorite thing to do. But if you don't follow me on Instagram, you wouldn't have known that I helped my friend cover his class at Pineapple when he was on The Greatest Dancer. So that was fun. I got to teach a class at Pineapple, but other than that, I haven't really done many classes. And once this whole situation is better, I'm definitely going to more classes because I need it. My base makeup is done, my brows are done. Should I do eyeshadow? It's literally a Zoom video call. Why am I getting ready? Yeah, I'm gonna do a bit of eyeshadow. Just do a little bit. Don't go too crazy. No, I say that, and then like 10 minutes later, you're gonna see me with like false lashes. No, I'm not gonna do that. I'm not gonna go that far. Speaking of, I mean, I wasn't speaking about water, but water. I'm drinking water. That must sound so weird to some of you, but if you know me, I can go days without drinking water, and I know it's bad. It's really bad. Like, water should be a thing that you should be drinking, like, every day. Like, it should be a no-brainer to drink water, but for some reason, I just don't drink water. But now that I'm home and I have this massive mug, I can go through like 3 mugs a day. Crazy, I know. Like, there was a time where I would drink one full mug of that big mug, and I was like,
wow. I'm changing my life like crazy times.
but now three? Who am I? But yeah, if you don't know me, why do I say like it's some kind of like an issue? Like, it isn't. I just don't drink water. I feel like I'm just constantly dehydrated. I've had three incidents where I've been really close to passing out because of dehydration. The first time was, how old was I? I think I was in either year 10 or 11. No, I think I was in year 11 because my sister was with me. And we were waiting for the bus in the morning. You know when you rub your eyes really hard and you get like those stars? I started getting stars, and like, my vision just started going white and my hearing started to go. I felt like I was going underwater. Like, it was all really muffly, and like, basically, like, my hearing was going, my eyesight was going. I was literally like, Kanan, I'm feeling dizzy. Like, I don't know what's happening. And the bus came. I somehow got on the bus, sat down, and everything was fine. So that was the first time I nearly passed out because I didn't drink water. Pfft, dumb. The second time was during sports ball in my first year. So I don't know if I filmed that. I think I did a get ready with me, or like the sports ball look, but I didn't really vlog the whole ball. I don't know. I'll link it somewhere. I think it's this side. It's gonna be so embarrassing if it's on this side, but okay, I'll link it here and in the description. But yeah, that day I hadn't eaten anything or obviously drink water at all. I had a small, it wasn't even like a big, but it was like a small bottle of alcohol. And I think it was because it was so hot. I was sweating. I was like running around taking pictures. And so when we're in line to get on a bus to the venue, again, my eyesight started going, my hearing started going, and I was literally like, I need shade. I need to sit down. And the first aid people came to me, so I was fine. It was a fun time. It was funny because all my friends were like, no, she can't go. Like, she spent so much money and time to get ready and she can't go. I'm like, guys, that's what you're worried about. You're not worried about my health or anything. But it was fine. I was just dehydrated. So I kind of collected myself. I was in the shade, got some water, ate some stuff, and was on the bus and made it to sports balls. That was fun. So that was the second time. I think that's enough eyeshadow. I think the more I talk about this, the more eyeshadow I'm going to put on and I'm just going to look like a clown. Which is not a good first impression. Even though it's kind of like an accurate representation of me. I feel like after those two times, whenever I feel a little bit dizzy or like have those, like my eyesight and my hearing is going, I like immediately go get some water. So I learned from those two experiences. So the last time, or like the third time that I like remember, because it literally happened last week. I mean, now that I look back at it, it makes sense why I was dehydrated. Because obviously like I didn't drink water and I had alcohol and was dancing. But so I was at a friend's house for a dinner and movie night, and like normally when I go out I have Jaeger bombs because they keep me awake and they give me energy, so you know, dance, because that's like the only part of going out that I like. Like if I go out to a club, I go to dance rather than like go for the alcohol, if you know what I mean. Dance or things.
So the reason why I'm talking about Jaeger bombs and like going out dancing in the club is because I usually have a few Jaeger bombs and other alcohol and I'm like fine. So continue the story.
But that night I had three Jaeger bombs and I was gone. Like obviously before I hadn't had that much alcohol, so I don't really know my limit, but like, I didn't think three Jaeger bombs is that much alcohol. So I was kind of like, whoa. Like I was like, whoa. But also like, whoa, I've only had three, so like why am I like this? It was kind of scary because my body was like sort of numb. Like I had to hold onto things to like walk to the kitchen. Anyway, so I had a crazy night at my friend's house. And then the next day I went to a dance class on 4 hours of sleep. So that was interesting. And I feel like when you go to a dance class, you should have a water bottle with you and you should be like drinking water. But obviously like me being me, I didn't have a water bottle and I wasn't drinking water. And then the next day we had a farewell get together for someone because they were flying the next day.
I had a bit of Fanta, so you know, liquids. But then we had a Jaeger bomb before we left, which I found really weird because like we were all leaving, so I was kind of like, shouldn't we have done the Jaeger bomb before? Anyway, we had a shot, and literally like when I got back to my friend's place that I was staying over at, I was just like talking to a friend. We were both standing up and I started feeling like dizzy again, like my hearing started going. Like I already felt a bit sick before, but I was like, surely I can't be sick from alcohol. I should have one shot, you know? So I was like, okay, this feels a bit weird. And I started seeing the stars and then my hearing started going. So I was like, okay, I'm just dehydrated. And so I was like,
sorry, I think I'm dehydrated.
So yeah, that was the third time that I remember being dehydrated and almost passing out. So, you know, that's fun. So stay hydrated, drink water, especially a time like this. So cheers. Delish. Should I do eyeliner? I feel like it's a bit much if I do eyeliner. But also, like, I don't have that many lashes. And they're not that long. So I think I'm going to do a little flick. So I'm going to do that off camera because I'm not going to talk as I do my eyeliner because eyeliner is stressful. So I'll be back when it's done.
All right, cool. I'm back. Did the eyeliner. Very, very minimal because if I do it any thicker or any longer, my hands will reach for my fake lashes and I don't want to go there for tonight because it's literally just a Zoom call. So what else is there to talk about? So I didn't really want to talk about this, but with what's going on right now, I feel like I won't talk about it much, but I did want to just mention it because as a Chinese person living in a Western place, Western country, what's happening right now because of the whole virus and it stemming from China, it doesn't justify racism. I've had a few verbal comments being thrown at me and like jokes and stuff. and people moving seats on the tube and the train just because I'm Asian. And the other day, I think it might have been yesterday or the day before, Wong Fu Productions posted a video highlighting the subject, so I'm going to put their video in the description and also in the cards. I feel like if you should give it a watch because basically it just touches on this subject and I don't want to talk about it, so go watch that video. Conclusion of this whole topic is just don't be racist. Like, think about other people's feelings. Just think before you say things and like do things, which I feel like should be the norm, but obviously it isn't. So anyway, back to happier topics. Just highlighting with my OG favorite highlighter. Literally have not strayed away from this highlighter since I started buying my own makeup here in the UK. So that would be like 3-4 years ago. So if you know the highlighter, you know, because I've said it in every, or like most of my videos here on YouTube and also in real life. Like, I've had people come up to me asking me my highlighter and I'm like, girl, you need to get on this. So yeah, it's my favorite highlighter. I feel like I really should fix up my hair. Well, I have time. Wow, I've been doing my makeup for 46 minutes. It's probably because I'm talking so much. I mean, I've got so much to like catch up on. I haven't been here for a whole year and 3 months. Like, a lot has happened in my life. I say that and I'm literally like struggling to think of what to talk about. I think it's because a lot of the things that I want to talk about, I am making a video about it, or like I have filmed it and I just need to edit it and upload it. So coming soon, so subscribe. Oh my gosh, I genuinely was just gonna do my lips and think that I was done, but no, I haven't even done my lashes yet. I literally do this so often. There's been so many times where I've like almost left the house without doing mascara, which like isn't really a problem. It really isn't. Like, makeup, it isn't a necessity, but I feel like I just feel more confident. I feel better when I have makeup on. So missing out on mascara is not an option. So how's everyone else doing? Everyone great? Let me know in the comments. Again, watch me get like one comment and it's gonna be for myself, to myself. So I hope you're doing great, Bethany. This is my ultimate favorite lip gloss. I mean, granted, I haven't really tried on many lip glosses, but this is great. This is the e.l.f. Lip Plumping Gloss. Doesn't really plump my lips that much, but the color is great and it's a lip gloss, so it looks cool and it makes the lips look full and juicy. Do you agree? No? Okay, cool. Just me? All right, cool. So that is the look for my face. Now I'm gonna work on my hair. Oh dear, this looks questionable. I think I'm just gonna brush it. I don't think I'm gonna do anything special for this call because, again, it's just a call. Oh my gosh, my hair is so long. Wait, I'm gonna try to show you how long it is right now. Oh, 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 can you see? So long. It's like past my waist. Makes sense because the last time I cut it was like, again, over a year ago. Wow, it is long and also like really thin. And now it's gonna be a while till I can cut my hair because I can't go outside. Everything that I'm complaining about or talking about is like such first world problems. Like, get yourself together. All right, cool. My hair is fine. Whatever. I'll just like do that. Now time to pick out a top. I'm not changing my bottoms because no one can see the bottoms. All right, so the outfit or the top that I've picked out is this nice vintage patterned top. And I'll show you my whole outfit because why not? So this top, and it's tied here. Not that anyone's gonna see it. And this is just my microphone. And some nice white Adidas shorts that no one's gonna see because they're just gonna see this bit. And I wanna finish off with some perfume, not because anyone can smell it, but because I want to finish off this get ready with me, like as if I was actually gonna go out, minus having no proper bottoms for this outfit. So yeah, that is my get ready with me video for my friend's Zoom birthday party. And oh my goodness, there is 30 seconds till the party starts.
Thank you.
Let's go.
So I'm just gonna finish this up. So thank you for watching my update on my whole life or like the past year. Give this video a like. If you want to see more from me, please subscribe. Now that I have time, I'm gonna be recording so much more and obviously like editing stuff from the year before and uploading them. So be sure to subscribe, click the notification bell if you want to get notified every time I upload. If you want to find me on social media, all my socials are @xbethanychanx, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye!